Good evening and welcome to the Planning Board meeting on December the 16th. Yes, it is today. Right, the first order of business are the minutes. Are any corrections or additions to the minutes for November 18th? If not, may I have a motion to...
Accept the minutes.
Second?
Second.
All in favor? We received today a memo regarding the Creto private access way. Janet Creto is requesting a private access way for an existing vacant lot. Lot number 4, located adjacent to her home at 112 Delano Park. And we have received a request from Bob Metcalf of Mitchell & Associates that this be tabled until the next meeting in January of 2009. Does anybody, if nobody has any objection, may I have a motion to table?
I'll move to table.
Second? All in favor? And the next item of business that we have is the Cox Farm Stand site plan. Jay, if you'll come up and explain any changes or additions or summarize anything for us, please. Anything different?
Sawyer Road, and I presented my farm stand proposal to the board last month, and there are no changes. I thought I'd recap briefly and then answer any additional questions and any questions from the public. I've been planting Christmas trees on my property on Sawyer Road near Fickett since 2003, primarily for pick your own or choose and cut sales. My first trees will likely be ready some this next year, if not the following. And I also want to build a farm stand to sell pre-cut trees, wreaths, ornaments, and other related items. I'd like to start construction in the spring. Just to go back over the site plan briefly, the existing buildings on the site are my house in addition right here. A shed building down here and a garage here. The proposed new structure is this L and barn right here. The entrance for the farm stand, the retail entrance, is on this gable end here. I put it here to keep it obviously away from Sawyer Road and from my house, the pedestrian and customer traffic. Pedestrian access, a pedestrian pathway, is from the parking lot in this area, behind this apple tree, and then into the retail entrance here. Buffering on the site is primarily through this row of mature trees along this property line, mature trees out here by the road, and the fact that the activity is here on the gable end away from Sawyer. Parking is in this area. This is an existing field, and the parking will be on the turf that's there. If necessary, I'll add gravel to keep this dry, but it's actually a dry, hard field, and I think it'll work well. As I said last month, my parents have been parking customers' cars on turf for many years, and it's worked out well. There's 13 spaces as required by the ordinance for the 2,000 foot maximum for sales there at the farm stand. And those spaces will be delineated by log curbing just to separate them from the additional parking in the field that will be used for the choose and cut. There is a curb cut here, and that will be to town standards. And in fact, the only modifications on the site are the building itself and that curb cut. There is a light on the gable end of the building here. There was a suggestion last month that I consider additional lighting for the parking area, and I've chosen not to include that light at this time. Hopefully, it won't be necessary. I think there'll be adequate lighting. If not, I'll come back to the board and request a additional light. It was also suggested that some pathway lighting be added here, and I will do that with temporary, probably solar-powered, small pathway lights, just to make it safe for pedestrians or customers. Basically, on the lighting, I need to get it built and then just see if it's an issue, and then if it is, I'll come back. And the only other comment I have is on the sign. It's still drawn as overhanging the right-of-way, but as I said last month, that will be built and installed according to the ordinance. I'll just put up the barn drawing. This is the building. It's a timber frame, 30 by 40 barn. The materials are cedar shake siding and either pine or spruce clapboards on the gables. Again, the retail entrance is here on the gable end. That's right here, and that's furthest from Sawyer Road. There'll also be a wall sign on above the entrance for the retail access. That's really all I had. I
can take any questions or...
Anybody have any questions before we have the hearing? Then I will call the public hearing. And if anybody has anything they would like to say, please come up to the podium, state your name and address.
Here? Mm-hmm. Hi, I'm Beth Engel. I live across the street. And that's beautiful. I'm looking forward to looking at it. I am part of the Farm Coalition, and I really enjoy buying my trees from his dad. And within probably a half mile of me, there's his dad and an excavator and hopefully Jay. And we like using our neighbors to help us and to promote buying local and having local services. I think this is fabulous, and I look forward to it.
Thank you very much.
Can I ask your address?
Yeah. 3 Young Lane.
Thank you.
It's right across.
Yep.
It's right off Thicket.
Thank you.
Thank you. Somebody else would like to speak? Anybody else? Public hearing is closed. Jay, do you want to come back up to the podium, please? Does anyone have any questions at all? Everybody's pleased with what we saw on the sidewalk. Very pleased. Right, if no one has any questions, do we have a motion for the board to entertain? Okay, Peter.
I have a motion for the board to consider. I move that based on the plans and materials submitted and the facts presented, the application of Jay Cox to construct a farm stand to support his choose and cut Christmas tree business and related agricultural operations located at 1148 Sawyer Road be approved subject to the following condition: that erosion control measures during the construction be installed at the direction of the code enforcement officer.
We have any discussion? I have one item for discussion. We might, since the plans do not reflect that the sign is out of the right of way at this moment, I think we should make that a condition. Isn't that what you said, that
yes.
The plans
yep.
do not at this moment reflect? So if nobody has any objection to that, adding a sentence about the sign.
So the motion's amended. The suggestion is to amend the motion for approval that the Did the plan show that the sign be removed from the right-of-way?
Or, well, I just had that the sign be moved out of the right-of-way and completely installed on the owner's property.
Okay.
Is that okay with everybody? Okay. Motion for the, do we have a motion for the amended?
No, I've amended my motion, so if someone else seconds it, we can bring it to a vote.
Okay. Any other discussion? All in favor? Lovely plan, Jay, and good luck.
Thank you very much.
We're all looking forward to seeing it.
Thank you, appreciate your time.
Okay, next item of business on the agenda is the Pipkin Private Access Way. Oh. Yes. Yes, if anybody has come in about the Credo property, is anybody here for the Credo property? Okay, well, just, I was just going to remind everybody that that's been tabled to next month. And Alan Pipkin is requesting a private access way for a new lot located at 22 Eastman Road. The application will be reviewed for compliance with Section 19-7-9, private access ways.
Is it possible to have the people that are representing the
Not 9:40, I hope. 7:40 must be.
Who are you?
I'm sorry, I'm available.
His name is right there.
Oh, it's not right.
Yes. Please, whenever you want to.
Hi.
Should I shut it down?
I'm shutting it down.
Welcome, everybody. We're from Jim Nettle Land Surveyors, and we're here representing.
Could you please introduce yourselves, too?
Yep. We're representing Alan Pipkin. This is Jim Nettle, and I'm Shane Haggett. And Alan Pipkin's proposing a land division and private access way at 22 Eastman Road. And I believe you all have copies of the plan, but we also put a copy of the plan up here on the board. So.
You'll have to tell us about the plan so that people who are watching, people who are here, and we understand completely, even though we've gone through it once before.
We'll review what we spoke about at the workshop.
Thank you.
This is an existing lot. It has a legal non-conforming dwelling on the lot right now, and the lot constitutes enough acreage to create a second parcel on it, but the second parcel does not have adequate access and roadway frontage, so we're proposing a private access way to obtain those space and bulk requirements for approval through the planning board. The current site right now slopes gently up towards the back of the lot. The existing surface drainage flows down from the back of the lot towards the road to an existing ditch here. It crosses and leaves the site in a westerly direction to an existing wetlands here that has been delineated by Jim Logan from Al Frick Associates. It has been delineated as an RP2 wetland with no setbacks required. We've slid the private way to the east to keep the right-of-way of the private way out of the wetlands, so we're not impacting the wetlands at all. The surface drainage enters the wetlands as it currently does now. This is what we're proposing as well. And then it leaves in a northerly direction underneath, through an existing culvert that crosses Eastman Road to the northerly side of Eastman Road. Eastman Road, I'm sorry. We received a letter from Steve Harden about stormwater. What we had discussed in the workshop was that we were asking for a stormwater waiver because we do not believe that the design here, if this roadway is built in accordance to the cross-section for an existing or proposed private way, the ditching will allow for the water to flow back to this existing ditch and exit the same way as it currently does.
Questions from the board? I have a question. Steve Harding talked about the sizing of the culverts.
Yes.
Have you included those now? They're not in our package.
Right. No, we have not. We have not because being a licensed land surveyor, I left that out on purpose at this point to come and speak with you that we will, as a further requirement of the approval, would be to have that properly sized by an engineer.
Okay.
We know that that was left out. The material in sizing of color has been left out.
Other questions about this at all? How about the site distances?
The site distances in Note 3 are actually pretty accurate distances, and Steve has asked us to take the more or less distances note off of it. That won't be a problem. I believe there's adequate site distance. We're just going to revise that note. We can graphically show it on the plan if you'd like. But we believe the site distance is adequate.
I think, do other people think that it should be shown on the plans? The site
well, it's
they
shown as a
note. Well, the note says more or less.
Right. It yeah. Seemed like Steve had a problem with the more or less, that he wanted a more
definitive
number. I think.
I thought you were proposing removing the whole note. So you're talking about just getting rid of the plus or minus reference. That's fine with me. Yeah. I don't need to see it graphically.
Right.
Anyone else?
No,
but I think the more or less might be.
We just put more or less because it's a visual thing, and to I guess it's more of the person who I am that to say that I can see 223 feet exactly down the road is it's just comfortable for me to put a more or less, but we certainly can take that off.
Does anybody have anything else? I have one more thing. Under number 4 of Steve's letter, it says, a submitted plan is not complete in this regard. It requires the location of all proposed and existing utilities, that they be shown on the plans.
Okay. We actually have. We do have a proposed water line and sewer line, and we're believing that he's only asking us for size and material. We actually show a location of the water and sewer now as a proposed going into parcel A. So we weren't really sure exactly what he was asking on that particular note.
Well, I see down here, proposed underground utilities, proposed shoreline. Okay. All right. Anybody, anything else?
What's the engineer said about the... the surface water, and you, is that something you left off, you said?
I did initially, and Jim may be able to expound on this a bit, is that not all sites, with my work and knowledge of engineering as a surveyor, so I have to be careful what I say, but not every site needs full engineering, and sometimes a site just naturally flows correctly, and when you put a new design on a site, the design of flow doesn't really change as far as what I believe is going on here. I think if we engage an engineer to analyze the site, my belief, his findings would be similar to what I believe, but that would, of course, be his opinion or her opinion that the surface drainage just flows naturally down here to this existing ditch. We would have to install a culvert and get a qualified engineer to determine an adequate size of the culvert. But the flowage is over to this RP2 wetland as it exists now. I think there's a little bit more sheet flowing that's going on now that would be impacted with Pipkin Way, but if the ditching is installed correctly, it all gets back to this ditch, back to the RP2 wetland, and then across Eastern Road as it currently does. So we've kind of stayed away a little bit on that, and that's why I believe at the workshop we brought up the whole stormwater waiver.
If I could just add one point. Jim Logan, the soil scientist and wetland scientist that did the work, I agree completely with Jim that the flow is gradually away from Eastern Road, though it's nearly level. It is definitely pitching back from the intersection at the proposed Pipkin Way where it would intersect with Eastern Road, and it does pitch gently back to this proposed culvert at that ditch line. A point of clarification on that ditch line, it actually terminates on the neighbor's property, and the outlet that feeds that is only a 4-inch pipe. It's a drain pipe. So I don't believe this to be a drainage ditch that's carrying a tremendous amount of water, so that I don't even know the importance of engineered review for culvert sizing, because typically that involves the calculation of a big square acreage of drainage area, and I don't believe that this particular culvert is fed by a lot of drainage. It literally is a 4-inch pipe. I did take a couple of photographs on site, and I did indicate to the DEP what the look of that was. It's not a whole lot of drainage coming through there to begin with. So
that four inches pipe is on your neighbor's yard.
What's that?
That 4-inch pipe is on your neighbor's yard, you said?
I believe the outlet. Well, I don't. You know, I believe the outlet is just over the line. Right. Is that your recollection?
We shot the ditch all the way up to the head of the pipe.
Yeah. So that was just over the lot line?
So that's the maximum that's coming over this property?
Correct.
It's what's coming out of a 4-inch pipe.
It appears to me like, and I was unable to verify this by talking to a neighbor. I never did get the chance to talk to the neighbor, but it appeared to me that it was probably a foundation drain. It's that black corrugated pipe that typically is put around a perimeter for either a garage, and I understood him to have an outbuilding over there. It looked to me like it might be coming from around his garage across the driveway. I have a photograph if you felt interested. The other thing is I did solicit DEP enforcement to come out and look at this wetland with me. There is a bit of a channel here at the head of the culvert. Clarified that it's not a stream. By their definition, no setback was indicated there. And I had the enforcement staff look at this drainage ditch with me, and they concurred that it was really minor. And I do have that written right here in this field determination form. I was delinquent. I didn't submit this, so I'll make sure this gets submitted into the record.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Excuse me. So I guess I just wanted, with the permission of the chair, you've read the letter that Steve Harding prepared.
Yeah.
It seemed like most of the stuff he was asking for were construction details, additional information. Is there any information there that you would be unwilling to provide in an additional submission for next month?
No, I don't have any follow-up.
The construction details of the cross section for the road?
There were. I just wanted to clarify for the board. I'm not hearing anyone really say they want you to do a full engineering study. I think most of the comments that Steve Harding was making was along the lines of he needs the culvert. If you're installing a culvert, he needs you to designate a size. He would like the size, materials, inverts of the proposed culvert should be added to the plans. He also wants additional information on how you plan to connect the sewer, your private sewer line to the proposed new sewer line. Clarify that it's going to the new proposed sewer line and not to an existing force main that's out there. So it seemed to me that was mostly construction details, and I just wanted to make sure it was, it didn't sound like there was a lot of disagreement. Is that fair?
I didn't hear that last sentence.
It doesn't sound like there's a lot of disagreement.
That's correct.
Okay. Nobody else? I'm sorry, go ahead.
I mean, the concern is we're dealing with complete list tonight. If we deem it complete and we don't get this information the next time, they're either back for another month or we deny the plan. So that's the applicant's risk. I'm not suggesting either one of those things are going to happen, but we want you to let us know if there's an issue with bringing this, you know, addressing this. And I'm hearing clearly, no, we'll have it submitted, because that's the risk you're running for the next meeting. Do I have, is that accurate? That's accurate.
Right. No, I think
okay.
Anybody have anything else? If not, we have a motion for the board to entertain.
I move that based on the plans and materials submitted and the facts presented, the application of Alan Pipkin for a private accessway for a new lot located at 22 Eastman Road be deemed complete.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Second motion, I move that the above application be tabled to the regular January 20th, 2009 inauguration day meeting of the planning board, at which time the public hearing will be held.
I'll second. Any discussion? All in favor? Okay, then the other thing we have to talk about is a sidewalk.
Do we want a sidewalk?
Does anybody feel we don't need a sidewalk or sidewalk, or does everybody feel we do need a sidewalk?
In January.
We live in Maine.
I'm really not inclined to do a sidewalk for this particular lot.
Anybody else?
Do you have any particular reason that you think we should take a sidewalk here from the planning staff's perspective?
As long as they meet everything you discussed, I would recommend that you actually sit down with Steve and make sure that you have everything in order, that have any questions that you have of him.
Scott made a suggestion that we may want to consider it for site distances. I'm still not inclined to do it, but if the rest of the board is inclined to do it for that reason.
I don't think
everybody comfortable. I mean, it's one lot, and
yeah. Well, you seem to have decent distances.
I just wanted to ask, would it be, I'm assuming the applicant would not have any problem with individual board members visiting the site on their own time, walking around?
Great. Yeah, I think we can go on our own and check site distances, certainly. So if everybody will do that when they're driving down Eastman Road.
I see a lot of cars slowing down. You'll know why.
Okay, anybody have anything else? Yep. I think we have a motion and a second, don't we, right now? Yes, we do.
Yes, I second.
Oh, no, we already voted on that. We were just talking about the sidewalk. Okay, so no sidewalk on your own. And if you have any questions, please call Maureen, and she will be delighted to help you. We always offer her help.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Happy holidays,
John. Motion to adjourn, second. All in favor?
Okay. We were done.
No, we actually had one shorter. We're off the air.
She made one.
No, wait.